live.
Thanks to JaoPhuket.net.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here live on Phuket's Live 89.5, it's the Roaring Boys! Absolutely fantastic. That is, right, welcome to the studio. That's the first time for sure having a banjo on the show, I think on the station.
Cheers for banjos.
Yeah, banjoing mad. Right, okay, so I welcome you, the Roaring Boys, and it's Joseph,
hi.
Tommy, and Paul.
How you doing?
Right, very good, very good. Right, okay, Roaring Boys. So let's talk about what you do and where you're from and what you're here doing in Phuket.
Yeah, well, basically, we're an Irish band. We mix it up a little bit, and we're here for a good time, really.
Okay, and where are you from originally, Joseph?
I'm a Blackpool lad.
You're a Blackpool lad. I actually asked that knowing that. Like, we're not too far away from each other. I think we know that. So you're a seaside lad.
Are you a Chorley boy?
I am a Chorley boy. Oh, Chorley boy. Yeah. But you've got roots in the music, no?
My old boy does a spot of singing after a few pints and that. Yeah, it's probably as far as it goes.
and how long have you been here?
I've been on the island for 11 years.
Right, okay, fantastic. Right, moving on to Tommy. How you doing, sir?
No bad, yourself, Jason?
I'm very good, and I'm really pleased to have you guys in the studio, because I've seen you play a couple of times, and I've wanted to get you in, and finally it's happened, and I'm loving the music, so absolutely brilliant. What's your story? How do you come here, and what's going on?
Well, I'm from Corby, Northamptonshire in England, and I've been here like 12 years on the island.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
And I've not asked yet, the Roaring Boys, how did you get together? How did you start?
Well, we all
Paul,
met here.
Paul, I'll let you tell the story. Move in a little bit, please.
We all met here. We were all on the island more or less at the same time, but with different bands. And one thing led to another. Half of this band broke up, half of that band left and went home. So we ended up working together. So far, so good.
And so you met here in Phuket, then?
Yeah, we all met out here.
Right, okay, excellent.
Coincidentally.
Crazy.
Well, you land on the island, you play a gig, and then you go and check out the competition, and these were the competition.
And then you recruit them, you get together.
That's it.
Brilliant. And, right, okay, so where'd you get the name, then?
The Roaring Boys, it actually comes from a song.
Stiff Little Fingers song. A guy, friend of ours, Simon, who was in the band at one stage as well, he named the band. His favourite band was Stiff Little Fingers. So one of their songs, The Roaring Boys.
They're a brilliant band because it's spelt a bit differently. Because like,
yeah, well, I banged their H in there because I'm a bit of a Celtic supporter.
Right, okay, so that's where that comes from. Because I thought
confused people.
I know, yeah. Well, I think it's nice. I was thinking it was Boys in the Ocean, like the sort of like the landmark. Well, not landmarks, the watermarks. You know what I mean?
Around.
Where's your main place you're playing at the moment? If people want to see you, I have actually put a Facebook link up there so they can connect with you and they can follow you in that weird sort of Facebook
world.
They can stalk you and everything. But where are you playing mainly?
Our main gig at the moment is in the Irish Times in Junksalon.
Yeah,
we're playing in there at the moment. You can catch us in there from 8:30 onwards on a Thursday, Friday, and on Sunday we do a Sunday session, Sunday carving and all that there. And from 4 o'clock onwards.
Excellent.
And that is a good session on a Sunday.
Last to introduce, Paul, like, where are you from and how did you end up?
I'm from Ireland. I'm from Wexford, which is the southeast of Ireland. They call it the sunny southeast. I'm not sure why it's always raining there, but nice little place. But same, I've been here on the island for more or less 11 years.
Okay, so you've all been here similar sort of a stretch
exactly,
of time, yeah?
Exactly.
And do you think you've stayed here a bit longer because you've joined as a band and you're kind of making it sort of like livable here?
Yeah, well, we weren't here permanently for the 11 years. We went away to Spain for a couple of years in the middle of it, and we spent a bit of time in Samui and a bit of time in Bangkok, but we're happy to be back in Phuket again now, to be working away in the Irish Times. That was the main reason we came back.
Excellent. So you went away as a band?
Mm, yeah.
Right, because I've checked out on some of your sites and that, some of the pictures and that, and I saw you've been back to Ireland and Spain and stuff. That's pretty cool. So you're tight as a band then?
Well, sometimes.
I've seen you live, and I think you're absolutely
many
brilliant.
Places we've had.
I've seen you live, and you are going to play us a little more music. Should we have another tune, and then we're going to have a little break, and then we'll come back for some more chat? Yeah.
Yeah.
Roar away, boys.
Bible.
My soul, my salvation at the turn of a card. My heart's red, black as cold. Cause everybody's got the right to go wrong. Everybody's gotta sing my song. Everybody's got the right to go wrong. Sing my song, sing my song. Oh, oh, glory, oh, I am the Lord's disciple. Stand, won't you shine your light on me? Come on, people, let the world begin. Come on, people, let the sun shine in. Come on, people, let the world begin. Let it in, let it in. Oh, oh, glory, oh, I'm the Lord's disciple. Down the Bible.
go to a short break. Stay with us, guys, here on Phuket's Live 89.5.
You're listening to Drive on Phuket's Live 89.5.
Absolutely brilliant, one of my favourites of all time, The Pogues and lads from The Roaring Boys. I've heard you, that's in your repertoire, I've heard you play that before.
Yeah, once or twice.
Yeah, a few times. Does it get requested a lot, or do you just...
It does, yeah, it gets requested a lot.
Or do you just, like, as soon as you see someone who might regularly come over, you're like, all right, we got it, in. Right, I'm going to talk, I want to go back to music now, like, talk about what inspires you now, what kind of got you into music and to be the band that you are now.
So, well, me, person-wise, my house is, my mother was a Seishawa woman, and she'd be cooking the food and she'd be listening to all, like the Sega. And the house is, you know, they've got the smell of curry and all the music going in there. And my old fella's a Belfast boy, so we had a Dubliners playing. And but I'd say what really got me into drumming, though, was probably the Jimi Hendrix experience. You know, I Mitch Mitchell, and that was it. I was away from there.
Right, okay, fantastic. So a mix, like a nice,
yeah,
nice
totally,
sort of
yeah,
like some
mix,
great music,
you know,
mix, and then sort of family bass,
yeah,
and then
some reggae, a lot of Irish trad, and you know, a bit of rock and roll.
Super cool.
Yeah, and then for me, it's like my mother's a Donegal woman in the north of Ireland. My dad's a Glaswegian, so I've got a lot of that Celtic blood in there. Like, but it never came out until I actually basically met these lot. Like, you know, I started playing it with the band that I came here first with, but that was my first introduction to it, playing it, and then meeting up with the boys. Then it's like, it was like push. We used to play a bit of rock and roll as well, like with it, but then we started pushing it towards, once the banjo got involved, we started pushing. Inspirationally, I don't know, I mean, I was a rocker, Thin Lizzy, Led Zeppelin, Jimi Hendrix, la la la, the same as the boys, like, and then, but then it kind of you want to get a little bit more authentic with instruments, like, and play a bit more raw, like, you know, with the real sound, like, you know.
Yeah.
Instead of, I mean, you would like to get loud all the time, but, you know, it's nice to be.
This is it, and especially with Irish music, because it's all
about dynamics.
It's all about the dynamic and the harmonies.
Yeah,
that the song just before the Pass Down My Bible, when the harmonies there, that was absolutely beautiful, you know. And it's like, that's something that I think really soars in music, and especially in a pub environment.
And it's coming back
for
now.
Sure.
Yeah, you know, it's never left, really. It's never left.
I mean, for what you think about it, you know, I'm doing this the global chart show on Sundays now, and basically Mumford and Sons, like that. Kind of like they've whammed in, like,
whammed
and
in,
it's
yeah.
big time popular, and that'll do a lot for like the live music and that kind of like
and it's raw,
it's raw and real music, isn't it? So
yeah, yeah.
Really cool. And I was gonna say, just before I pass it on to Paul, Tommy, so that was not your first band ever when you came to Phuket?
No,
I was gonna say, you can't tell me you're new to this game.
I was with a band for 9 years in my hometown. We were called the Little Green Men.
Oh, brilliant.
You know, and basically, yeah, we did a lot of original stuff, and, you know, toured Europe. And
I was gonna say you're too good and confident with the mic and the guitar.
Yeah, we did well. Nearly got there. Not, you know, the old scenario there. Nearly there. Not there. Then
you were in it and taking part.
Yeah,
and
took heavily part in it. Yeah.
Well, we all come from you know, playing original music for years before coming over to the island.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and that's it. So, like, cool. Yeah. So you're like, this is it. It's kind of like now just entertaining for the full sort of like force of giving people what they
get
need.
Get out there and play some gigs.
Excellent.
Hang it out.
Yep. Okay, Paul.
For me, very similar to the guys. I grew up listening to the Dubliners and that kind of thing in my dad's car. He always had it on the radio. But I was more, at the time, I was more interested in rock and heavy metal. Really, I used to go to Megadeth gigs and all kinds of things. But what happened to me was the first time I joined a band and we went on tour. And I didn't really know much Irish music, but the guys started playing, you know, with a fiddle in the band. And when I saw the reaction of the crowd, it was like, yeah, I'll have a bit of this. So it's from then on, that's probably 15 years ago, and I've been loving it ever since.
And
keeping it going.
I'm very, very good at it as well. Very good at it. This is another thing on the global charts as well as the albums as well. It's talking about it coming back. There's a couple of characters, I don't know if you've heard of her, but this guy, Keith Harkin, who's like, he's big time, he's like an Irish lad, and he's doing really well in America, it's going all over the world. And also, there's like, in the top 10 albums on sales alone, there's a group called Celtic Thunder, which he's in with, and also Celtic Woman, which is a bunch of girls, and they're pretty good to watch as well.
The whole show.
It doesn't really matter, but she's playing the fiddle, but spinning and spinning and spinning round, and it's like, wow, how's she keeping it up? Tune and that. Right, absolutely brilliant. What's happening coming up gigs then next, like sort of in the horizon for the Roaring Boys?
Horizon wise, well, as you say, we've got a regular gig up to the end of November at the Irish Times, and then the Crack also in Laguna.
Right.
On the Saturday evenings, and we'll just
the Crack wait. Spell C R A I C.
Yeah.
There's a big dude coming up this Friday actually in the Irish Times. It's a singles event, so you know, if you're single, get involved. If you're not, kid on you are.
There you go. If you're single, you fancy a bit of good music, and
I think you shout out to Claire Ratcliffe, she'll know if she's about.
I think that's from 8 till 10. There's 2-for-1 cocktails. There's a few things going on, a bit of scrant, and should be a good night.
Okay, if you're single and up for it, get yourself down to the Irish Times Junk Salon, and there'll be a load of good stuff, and also the Roaring Boys will be playing. I've got to say as well. Big respect to Tommy, the Irish Times, because do you know what? On my last birthday, he was the only guy in the whole of Phuket, the only guy who bought me a drink.
Yeah?
Only guy who bought me a drink on my birthday. Top notch. Cheers, Tommy. Thanks for that.
The Irish Times, top
big,
man.
Big respect. Big
top
respect. Man. So that's what's coming up for the Roaring Boys. Absolutely brilliant. So you're playing at the Crack and the Irish Times.
Yeah, Saturday night's in the Crack.
And basically, I've put up the Facebook, as I said before, so the Roaring Boys are up on our Facebook page as well. You can link up and find out where they're going and what they're doing.
Follow us.
And thanks ever so much for coming in, guys.
Thanks very much.
Cheers. Absolute pleasure to have you, and a bit of live music on the show. Go well, and good luck to you in the future.
Thanks very much.
Cheers, pal.
Take it away.
Why fall, my daddy-o, there's whiskey.
Absolutely spot on.
Thanks, Jason.
You're listening to Drive on Phuket's Live.